gentlemen, this is not a drill.
My name is Samuel Brown. I'm a member of the Mala AME Church. I am a trustee. And at this moment, I would like to honor my pastor, Reverend Grant, Isaac Grant, and his family. Honor guests and our graduates. I have this task to say a few words of encouragement. I'd like to encourage you to or extend our encouragement, our involvement in your life. You, Mount Olive, have watched you grow from babies now to adults. Now you are ready to enter into this great world that God has prepared for you. I would like to say to you that do the thing that you were taught. Listen, study, present yourselves as adults. God has given you this opportunity in this time, the year of the Lord 2020, June 7th, you will enter into this new world of this new challenge. And we hope that you learn to trust, listen, and know your local government. Our pastors stand ready to listen to you if you want to call. We are here at Mount Olive, would like to continue to keep you in our prayers as you continue to grow. We thank you so much. Hope you continue your studies in higher education. No matter what your job is, try to do the best you can, and God will do the rest. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Donald Harmon. I am the steward pro tem at Mount Olive AME Church. First, giving honor to our Savior Jesus Christ, who is the head of our life, our honorary pastor, Reverend Grant, and his lovely wife, Mrs. Grant. We at Mount Olive AME Church would like to congratulate the class of 2020. We've seen you come up through Mount Olive AME Church for many years, and you have grown up to be fine young men and young ladies, and we just extend our hand to you to help you along the way, and just hope that you will remember some of the things that you have learned here, because we put a lot of stuff in you, so I know eventually that it will come back to you and come out. So we at Mount Olive, again, I would like to say, would like to congratulate you, class of 2020, because 2020 has been a year of many challenges. We have seen many things that I would say, well, it's not a first in this world, but it's the first that we have seen. And we here at Mount Olive and the United States have met these challenges head on, and hope that you will do the same with life. All the challenges that you meet in life, we would like for you to spearhead and meet these head on and do the best that you can throughout the rest of your life here on this earth. So just take heed and thank you. As you go through this life, just don't do everything that you can do and you're bigger and bad enough to do. Think and make good decisions through life. Thank you.
We give all the praise to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We honor our pastor of Mount Olive AME Church, Reverend Isaac Grant, and to the parents of all the graduates. To God be the glory for great things he has done. This is the day, graduates, your day that the Lord has made. Go ahead and rejoice in it and be glad about it. Graduation is a milestone in your life, for it is a great accomplishment. 12 years, 16 years, 18 years, whatever, it's a long time. We know some days it hadn't been easy, study hadn't been easy. It was very challenging to you. But with God being on your side and your parents, you made it, you did it. As you move on from high school to college, or whatever endeavors in your life that you chooses, always pause to prayer and give God thanks and praise. I pray for you graduates that your faith in God grows stronger, your commitment grows deeper with every new challenges you meet. Psalms 23, the Lord is my shepherd. Read it daily and keep it in your heart. Proverbs 14:12 says, there is a way which seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof, the ways of is death. In other words, some decision, even things you might seem right or decisions you about to make, it seems right, it looks right, it looks good, but it might not be the right thing to do. So go to Proverbs 3:5-6. It says, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not unto thy own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Depend on the Lord at all times. We encourage you to stay focused. Always remember home training. Always remember home training. And your own mind. Keep your own mind. Think for yourself. Always be aware of the company and friends that you choose. On behalf of your pastor, Reverend Isaac Grant, your parents, Mount Olive Church family, and myself, Sister Grant, congratulations. God bless you always. And again, we say congratulations. We love you. Amen.
Happy 2020 graduates! Yay! Congratulations to our 2020 graduates, college, and high school. As you embark on the new life ahead of you, don't let what you cannot do interfere with what you can do. Strive for progress, not perfection. And don't let your weaknesses allow you to give up. The most certain way to succeed is always try one more time. May God bless you and keep you, and may his face shine upon you. Good luck to each and every one of you on your future endeavors.
Hey. Congratulations!
Alexis Goodwin, daughter of Thomas and Linda Goodwin.
Yes.
Derek Brown, grandson of Gary and Dale Brown.
Yes.
Asherelle White, daughter of Kimberly White.
Yes.
Josiah Green, son of Shawanda and Johnny Green. Taylar Grant, daughter of Lanisha Grant, granddaughter of the Reverend Isaac Grant and Sister Grant. James Mack, great-grandson of Mother Sarah Brown. And now our college graduate, Courtney Myers, graduate from the University of South Carolina, Aiken. Daughter of Dorothy Myers. And our one and only Reverend Jonathan Howell, Joshua Howell, graduate from Payne, Theological, Seminary.
Yay! 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 Yeah.
class of 2020. We know that for the past 5 months, four to five months, it has been a challenge to you. For the coronavirus, COVID-19, has sent everything in different ways. And for you, it's taken you, took you to a place that you've not been before. It has deprived you of having, experiencing some of the wonderful things of being a graduate. And we say this to you on all levels, for the virus has taken some of those things away. But I want you to know that although some things have been taken away, I want you to know that you will go down in history. For whenever 2020 is mentioned, your name will be in that history because of what the virus has caused. And so don't be discouraged. Don't feel bad. Know that you have triumphed over this scourge that is upon the earth. And look at what God has allowed, where he has brought you from and what he has brought you through. He's brought you to behold another watershed, another time in your life, another crossroad in your life. And so we do congratulate you and know that what is ahead of you is more than what is behind you. So we say to you, take advantage, even with the difficulties, with doing things differently. Take advantage of all that is presented unto you. And then we cannot say congratulations to you without saying to parents of our graduates, we commend you. We commend you for your stamina, for what you have done in this time. This time of not normalcy, but abnormalcy, doing things in a different way. To all of our parents, grandparents, and all others, we say to you, God bless you, and we thank you for the work that you've done. And again, we pray that you, our graduates, continue to press forward and to be all, strive to be all that you can be. And not allow what has happened to you within the last 4 or 5 months, not allow that to cause you not to strive to become the best that you can be. Remember, if God be for you, who can be against you? God bless you. Continue to strive. Amen.
For the rest of y'all ready? Put them in the air, say blessing. Come on, say blessing. Come on, say blessing. Oh.